Bon dia, this morning we're going to make test tube vases with wooden stands out of this. And the end result will look like these. So the first step of the process is to find the beautiful live edge offcuts that you're going to be using for the stand. So that's what we're going to go and do now. So the first one we're going to do is with this piece of wood here. I have no idea what the wood is. I think it might be cedar. It's a shame we can't do scratch and sniff, eh? Yeah, let's get started on this. Break down the process. So what we're going to need for this particular test tube vase stand, 22 mil fours and a bit, 22 mil diameter test tube. And the ones we have are how long? 15 centimeters long, but obviously they come in different sizes, so you must just adjust accordingly to whatever you have. Big old hole saw and the piece of wood that we're using. So we've got the piece of wood in the drill press, going to drill the big center hole out. Quite a hefty hole saw this, so I've clamped down the piece in the way that I have my makeshift way to try and save my fingers. Let's see how it pans out. This is too thick for my hole saw, so I've gone down as far as I can here. It's almost put the pilot hole through the other side, but not quite. So I'm going to use my drill just to finish that off. And we'll turn it over and do it from the other side. There we go. We've got the hole now done. As you can see, that's quite a wedge, so it's a little tricky to do because obviously it's easier if it's a nice flat surface. We got there in the end. Bit of Dremel sanding inside there, it'll look nice. Now we're going to drill the hole for the test tube. Okay, so we drilled the big hole for the display of the test tube inside. We've drilled the test tube hole. Now I need to use a Dremel to tidy up where the hole saw left a few marks. So we're going to do that now. This has been very rough sawn from the lumberyard with a chainsaw, and it's left a big notch here that looks a bit crap. So I'm going to use the flush cut saw to level it out a bit. All right, so we've sanded down the bit of cedar. Looks really nice, the grain's come through nicely now. And now I'm gonna apply some oil to it. It's called Osmo, weirdly enough. Right, so for the next stand, we're going to be using the offcut from the previous stand that we did. Remember, I cut a big hole saw into the center of it. That'll be the base of this stand. And this will be the connecting piece, which is a piece of aluminium tubing that's supposedly 10 mil, but I think is actually a bit less. New piece, 22 mil by 15 centimeter test tube. 22 mil fours and a bit, and I think this is a 65 mil fours and a bit, and we will make another variation. So with this piece, it's been cut with a chainsaw on quite an angle, so I'm going to cut it flat here. I gave up on drilling the hole for the moment because it's actually very dense, this wood. So I'm going to drill the hole for the test tube here. The bottom of this is all curved, so I've had to clamp this to a big offcut to try and keep it upright. And I think that should do the job. So let's see. So this is the pipe we're going to put in the bottom, the aluminium pipe. As you can see there, it's 9.7 millimeters and not 10 mil. So I can't use a 10 mil bit because it'll be too loose, and it's going to be too large for a 9.5 mil bit. So what we'll have to do is drill a 9.5 mil hole, and then I'm going to cut a couple of reliefs into here so we can jam it in. Well, that took a lot longer than I thought it would. That's a very dense wood. Plus, it's very small. And I had to drill a big hole for this test tube. So what I ended up doing is using a piece of scrap ply and firing some brad nails into the back to hold this in position. and then I could clamp it down to my drill press. As you can see, my first effort didn't result in anything good. So this actually worked quite well, but it took a long time to get through this. So yeah, anyway, we've done it. Now we're gonna put the stand together. Oh no, we're not, we're gonna sand. My favorite. Mark's Mallet is getting its first outing today. This bad boy has been around the world. It got posted from Australia to here in Portugal. Portugal decided they would send it back to Australia. Then Mark tried again, sent it from Australia to the UK. We went to the UK, got it in the UK, came all the way back to Portugal. And today is the first day I'm getting to use it. So I'm going to christen it by hitting something with it. In this case, a chisel. Yeah. So we've done the other stand, sanded, finished. Time for our friend Osmo. So let's give that a crack. Oh, and by the way, these are what are called painter's triangles. It's to, when I Osmo the bottom, put them on there. There's less points of contact. Means it won't stick to the work surface. Right. So this is the finished product. Products. This one's drying, so it's not quite finished. Doesn't matter. They look good, as you can see. Well, if we do say so ourselves. The tricky part of this project is that, as you can see, I mean, that's really not square, obviously, because it's like live edge stuff. So drilling and lining things up, that's the hard part. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward. This one's cedar, smells very nice. This one, very dense, hardy as fuckarious, I think. Definitely was quite hard to draw through this one. As you can see, it looks really nice. Can be a very nice addition to your home. Make your wife very happy, and as everyone knows, happy wife, happy life. So if you don't want to make your own, little plug for ourselves here, on our website we actually make test tube vase stands, so I'll put a link down below, you can have a look. And even if you don't want to buy, just have a look anyway, might give you some ideas making your own. If you've already made some, fantastic, link below as well, put it in the comments. And if you've made it this far, well done. You'll be receiving your certificate of completion in the post shortly. Thank you very much for watching. Please comment, like, subscribe, the usual. We appreciate it. Welcome to Michael's Styling Tips. we have the finished articles. Ta-da! They look good, eh? With bamboo. And I believe this is called Monstera. If I'm wrong, please feel free to correct me in the comments. I'm always willing to learn new things, and it wouldn't be the first time I've been wrong about something. So, we got these now. These, we think, highlight how beautiful test tubes can be. But you can use any cutting. You can go out and pick flowers, use lavender stalks, whatever. As long as it fits, obviously, within the diameter of the test tube. I mean, that goes without saying, really, doesn't it? Keep an eye on the water level. Don't let your plants die, it would be a shame. It kind of takes away from the look of everything. Good rule of thumb, as you can see here, it's about 3/4 full. And when it comes time to water, take the test tube out, take it to the tap or use a beaker of water to fill it up. Don't take the stand and the test tube to the tap because it will obviously get very wet. And wood and water don't really mix very well.